Hello and welcome back to the third video of our WordPress Beginner to Advanced course, where our ultimate goal is to become job ready to start providing freelance services on Upwork, Fiverr, or on any other freelance marketplaces. So in our previous lessons, we learned about the basics of WordPress, which you should know if you are planning to get into this career. And in the second class, we learned how to set up a local server on our own computer so that we don't have to purchase a domain and hosting to start creating websites and start practicing and learning the process. And then we created our very first website throughout the second lesson. And in this video, we are going to talk about the WordPress backend and dashboard, and we are going to talk about all the other tools available on the backend. So without further ado, so if you have missed my previous videos, you are going to find these videos in both of those playlists, and I'm going to attach this playlist link into the video description for you, so you can access these previous videos easily. So without further ado, let me take you here. First of all, let me show you one error. So here we have created, as you can see, localhost slash my website. If I hit enter, it is going to show us an error. Here we go. And the reason is we didn't started our XAMPP server. So let me just open XAMPP from here. XAMPP control panel. So you have to open up your XAMPP control panel, and then you have to start Apache and MySQL module to start being able to view the website or customizing whatever you want. So let me just click on start and start for MySQL. So both of the Apache and MySQL is now in running mode. Let's just minimize this one. And now if I just reload this page, we are going to find out that we are being able to access our newly created website. Now, let me take you to our WordPress dashboard. And again, in my previous video, I have mentioned or showed how you can go to your WordPress backend. So let me show you again, wp-admin. So you already know the process. So we are going to provide our username and password, and we created every information in the last video. So let me just go back here, and here is our username and password. So you should already created your username and your password, and you have settled up everything for WordPress backend. So let me just copy and paste this information here, and then let me click on login. And here we go, we are on the WordPress backend, and or we're on the WordPress dashboard. And as you can see, now we are going to talk about everything available here, and you're going to I'm going to give you some information regarding these panels as well. So here, as you can see, dashboard, welcome to WordPress. And then here we have WordPress is mentioning us some next steps. As you can see, you can start creating your first blog post, you can start adding your pages, and they're suggesting the about page, set up your home page, and view your site. So if you click here, we are going to be able to see our site. If we click here and actually hover over here, and you are going to find this visit site, you can visit our site from here, right? So let me just cross them out from there. And then you have got manage widgets, manage menus, turn comments on or off, learn more about getting started. So basically, I'm going to open up my blog site, Learner's World, and I'm going to give you some examples here. And let's say Azharul Rafy, which is my portfolio website. I'm currently working on it, so it will be much improved, hopefully. So let me just explain here. So first of all, as you can see, they're telling us to get started to customize our site. So if I click on customize your site button from here, we are going to find all these options from where I'll be able to change our logo. We are going to be able to change our site identity information. So if I just click here, as you can see, site title, I can change this site title to something else. I can change this tagline to something else. So if I just hover over, you are going to see here, as you can see, my new WordPress website, just another website, because this is here written. So if I just make a change here, this is our, okay, first website as an example, okay? And if I just click on publish and let it be saved, okay, so it's been published. Now if I reload this page again, and or if I take you on a new tab, we are going to find, let me show you, if I hover over here, you are going to find this is our first website after the site name, right? So this is the way the prettiest way or the easiest way how we can customize our website. So let me just take you back here. So we are going to talk about the customizing thing. We are going to make beautiful portfolio websites, e-commerce website, business website, agency website, and many other types of website throughout the course. So don't worry, we're going to talk about these things later. And as you can see here, site health status, it is going to show us about if there is any error available or not, and some of the information which we are going to learn about in our future videos, so we don't have to talk about these things. And from here, this quick draft, if you have got a certain idea on your mind, you can simply type out information about that idea and then just keep a draft for it, so that you'll be able to go back here on your post tab and then you'll be able to customize this post to make it. So I don't want to talk about these things as of now, because if I talk too much about these things, you might going to get confused if you're a beginner here. So here we have got, at a glance, we have got currently one demo post, one demo comment, five demo pages available on our WordPress. It comes along with the installation, and currently we have got WordPress 5.6 running with 2021 theme, which is 2021, the current year. Okay, so WordPress most likely publish one themes each year. All right, and then we have got this activity where people, as you can see, recent comments, someone has made a comment here, which is really a default comment, and you can simply see the options, unapprove. You can unapprove the comment, you can reply to the comments, edit spam, trash. So we are going to talk all of these things later, but first of all, let me talk about these sidebars, and these are the information which are real important things to know about. So as you can see, after landing on the WordPress dashboard, if I just reload again, you'll be landed here on the dashboard. Then you are going to find this home tab, which we are currently on the dashboard homepage. So we are being able to see all the information here. And then you are seeing this update step. So if I click on updates, we are going to find all the information regarding where we have to make the updates. As you can see, current version is 5.6 here, and you have the latest version of WordPress. So from this page, you will be able to update your WordPress version itself. So if I want to show you from here, let's say wordpress.org, if I take you here and if I click on get WordPress and download and install, you are going to see that the current version is here, 5.6, which we have downloaded and installed in our previous video. So we have got the latest version, so it is showing us you have the latest version of WordPress, but you might going to see that the version might be changed, 5.7, 5.8, then you have to make some updates from here. So you can do this by simply clicking on this update button, which will be appeared here. And then we have got, they're suggesting, as you can see, plugins. The following plugins have new versions available. So Akismath anti-spam, so we can simply click here and then click on update plugins so that the plugin will be updated, but we are going to skip this for now. And then we have got this theme. As you can see, the following theme have new versions available. Check the ones you want to update and then click updates. So this theme has, although we have got the new theme, but this theme has an update, so they are suggesting us to make the update. So we are going to skip all the update things for this video. We are just going to learn about the backend throughout this video, and we are going to make the other stuff in our coming videos step by step. So let's just talk about this post section. As you can see, this post section, and from whenever we are hovering over our cursor here, we are seeing all posts. So if I open up this link in a new tab, let me keep it open, we are going to find all the posts that we have made. It could be published, it could be scheduled, it could be, let's say, draft. We are going to see all the post list available there. And then we have got this option, add new. So this option, you already know. So this option is to create a new post, publish a new post on our WordPress website. So I'm going to talk about this and show you some examples soon. And after that, this category. So let's say you have got a website for passive income, and you are going to talk about how to make money on YouTube, specific how to make money as a freelancer in a passive way, second category. So you can simply categorize them, like you have made a post about how to make money on YouTube, and then you just specified this blog post with the category of YouTube. And then let's say you have created a post with the category of, let's say, how to make money passively as a freelancer, then you can categorize it freelancer. So if I just show you an example here, Actually, it would be better if I just notice, if you just notice here, whenever I am hovering over on learn, I am seeing that freelancing is a category, YouTubing is another category, blogging is another category. So if I just open this link in a new tab, and if I just open this link in a new tab, these are listed with categories. So you are going to find all the information about freelancing here. How to start freelancing, email marketing, as I have mentioned something here about freelancing. So I keep this post under freelancing category. And then as you can see, how to become a virtual assistant, best graphic design courses, and all the poster about here, all the poster about freelancing. And then if you just come here, you are going to find that how to start a YouTube channel, because we are visiting all the post about which are listed with YouTubing category, and we are going to learn about these stuffs step by step. So please don't worry. So as you can see, all the posts are about this YouTubing. So let me take you back here again, and then we have got this text. So let's say you have created about freelancing, you have created 100 posts or more than 100 posts, or let's say 1000 posts, who knows, you might going to continue writing posts. And then if you just want to get some posts easily, you can categorize them, or actually you can define them with some specific tags. So that, let's say I have started, like I have added some tags here for this post, how to start freelancing. So I can put it start freelancing, and then for this post, let's say this one, start freelancing, and for let's say this one, start freelancing. So if whenever I'll try to use start freelancing tag on somewhere on this website, maybe on the search bar, I'm going to find all the posts available with this start freelancing hashtag or tag, actually not hashtag, tag. All right, so we are going to learn more about these things in our future videos. So you might going getting some confusion if you are a complete beginner, so pardon me, but I'm just trying to give you the best information possible. All right, so these are the things. So I have created opened this page, as you can see here, from all posts. Again, let me take you back so it would be organized. All right, so all posts, we have got currently one post which came along with the WordPress installation, right? So we are seeing one post here. Now we'll be able to edit this post, we'll be do quick edit, we can make it trash so that it won't be available here on our all post section, it will be here on trash. So let me just let me just show you by clicking here on this trash button, and you are going to find that we have got no post available on our WordPress site, but it is available on trash. Now if I want to restore it, I'll be able to do this. I can restore this post, or I can delete this post permanently. So let me just restore so that I'll be able to give you some more hints. So if I click here, we are going to get that again all post, as you can see, on draft. And as you can see, who is the author? The author is Rafy, which is me. In your case, you are going to be the author, or whoever the person managing the website, they are going to be author. And then here we go, we have got the category, and we are going to learn about this category thing in our previous future videos, right? And then tags, and then we have got this comment section. You are going to find all the comments about this post, and then last modified, or when the post was published, all the information available here. And now let's say you want to create your new post, create a new post. How you can do this? Simply, if you click on add new button, or if you click on this add new button, or you can hover over here, and then if you click on this post button, all three sections or all three options are going to work same for you. So let me just click here on add new, and as you can see, I'm going to click on cross. As you can see, now we have got the interface to start adding our content. So here we are going to provide our title, we are going to provide all the contents here, then we are going to do all rest of the settings of this post here, right? And we are going to talk about this in our future video or the next video, right? So let's go back. I'm going to cross it out. Then we'll be able to categories in the next video as well, and we are going to talk about tags in the next video as well, so please don't worry. Now let's go for the media section. So in the media section, whatever content we are uploading, not content actually, whatever image, videos, zip file, and the visual things actually, whatever we are uploading on our website, we are going to find them on this library section. So if I click on library, okay, so we have got nothing here because we didn't uploaded one single image yet. But when we are going to start creating blog posts, we are going to add featured image, we are going to add other image or videos maybe, and these are going to be appearing here, most likely mostly the image stuffs, right? And then we have got, like library add new. If we click here, we are going to find this upload button so that you'll be able to upload images, videos, and whatever it is. And we can upload, the maximum file size is here 40 megabyte. It depends on your server. If you can increase the size of this limitation, then you can upload, let's say, 500 megabyte as well, 200 megabyte as well. So it depends on your hosting server, right? And then we have got, let's say, pages. So here are the pages. As you can see, all pages add new. So from all pages, again, you are going to find all the pages available on your website as of now. And currently we have got these default pages, as you can see, about, blog, content, create your website with blogs, privacy policy, sample page. These are the pages available as of now. And if you want to create a new page, you can simply click here on add new, and then the same process as we have done, or actually as we are going to do for the post, we are going to do the same here for the pages as well. And if I want to explain some more information, as you can see here on my website, I have got home, this is one page, about is another page, learn is another page, contact us is another page. So if I just open up this contact page, this is a page, right? So this page is containing many information about me, right? How to contact me, my phone number, my email address, and other stuffs, right? And here I have got the Udemy links or whatever it is available. So these are the examples of pages, and we are going to create new pages by clicking on add new, right? So we are going to learn more about this next for sure. And then we have got this comment section, from where we'll be able to moderate the comments. Like if you want to approve a comment, you can approve it. If you want to disapprove or unapprove, we can unapprove them. We can trash them. We can make a spam. If someone just do some spamming, we can mark it for spam. We can reply on a comment from here as well. So we are going to learn these stuff as well. So let's go for appearance. This is one of the mostly used and most important part also. So as you can see, from appearance you are going to find information about your theme. You are going to find information or find the option to customize your currently active theme. Then you have got the widgets. So what are widgets? So first of all, let me talk about these themes. As you can see, we already know we are using 2021 theme. So if I just take you to themes from here, you are going to find we have got on our WordPress, we have got 2020, 2019, and 2021 theme installed. But we have currently got 2021 is active. But if you want to activate this one, simply we have to click on active button here. But we are not going to do this. It is we are going to upload themes, custom themes. We are going to upload premium themes in our future videos. For now, let's move on. We are going with this customize option. So let's click on customize, and we're going to find the same things we have already seen in the first part of this video. So let's go back, and again, you can customize everything. You can customize the color of this blog site. Let me show you an example. If I change it, just take a look. All right, so color has been changed. Just take a look how it is looking like. So we're going to keep it as it is. I'm going to cross this out, and we're going to talk about this letter. Now let's go for widgets. So what are widgets? So these are the things you are going to find. As you can see, I have got this widget here, which are custom code images added for my courses. And if you notice, I don't have any widgets. So this one is a footer widget, right? So this one, as you can see, email subscription. So this one is a widget. So I have made this using an email widget, and we are going to learn about these things later. So widgets are basically being used for, let's say, for the sidebars, for the footers, although I don't have anything here on my footer widget here. And then some people also place widgets here on this right after their header section, and then some people place widgets on their left side bar as well. So we are going to learn about these things as well, and these are really easy to use. As you can see, simply drag and drop, and you are going to customize everything. You are going to be able to customize everything as you need by using widgets, and many more functionalities, many more features you can add. Actually, features, maybe functionalities or options you can add on the sidebars or whatever you want throughout your blog or website. And now let's go for this menu section. So we are going to create menus, obviously. And as you can see, currently we don't have a menu. If I visit on the website, we don't have, so I have got already menu here, as you can see, home, about, contact, blog and contact. So by default, we have got these menus, but we are going to create custom list so that you'll be able to learn step by step. So we are going to work on these menu things as well. And then we have got the background. So again, it is landing us to this background, and you can actually, instead of this color, you can choose an image for the background to be displayed. So let's just keep it as it is as of now. So let me take you back. And then you have got theme editor here. If we need custom codes to be enabled here, then you can simply put your codes. If you know HTML, CSS, PHP, JavaScript, then this is the place for you. Other than that, we don't have to touch this field ever. Now let's just move on. Let's move for plugins. As you can see, from plugins, you are going to from the first option, you are going to find installed plugins, all the plugins currently installed on your website. And from this one, you can add new plugin. And then from this one, you are going to be able to edit your plugins if you have got the coding skills. So now with plugins, we build functionalities, we add functionalities in our WordPress website. So these are really a big aspect, a major part of a WordPress management or WordPress managed website, because using plugins, we can make a website, simple website as an e-commerce website. Using plugins, we can do SEO stops on our website. Using plugins, you can add these pop-up forms, these sign up forms, whatever it is. So we are going to learn about this for sure. So let me just show you at a glance here. I'm going to click here on plugin, and it is going to show me all the plugins available here on my website as of now. We are actually on installed plugins. Let me just take you back on dashboard again. And if I hover around plugins, you are going to find this option, installed plugins. If we click here, we are going to visit on the same page, right? So currently we have got Hello Dolly and Akismet Anti-Spam, these plugins installed, although they are not active on the site. So we are going to talk about this later. And then we have got add new. So if you want to add a specific functionality on the website, you can simply click on add new button from here, and you are going to find, as you can see, thousands of plugins you are going to find. Let's say social here. And you are going to find hundreds of thousands of plugins based on the availability, and you will be able to make beautiful, beautiful functional effects on your website using plugins, right? So now let's just go for, and we are going to show you, I'm actually going to show you how to add, how to set up plugins for a better functionalities on your website. And then we have got plugin editor. I don't want to go there because I don't have these skills yet. And still I'm being able to provide the services. So please don't worry. You don't need, at the initial stage, you don't need coding skills to start providing freelance services with basic WordPress tasks. You can do WordPress installation. You can set up a complete website from the scratch, still without the coding stuffs, right? So now, and even if I just show you some examples, if when they're in front of my eyes, why shouldn't I show you? This website I have created myself. I didn't had the coding skills. And this website I created by myself, I didn't have that coding skills, right? So you don't have to worry about these stuffs yet. Now let me just take you back here. And then we have got users. From here, you are going to find all the users, user accounts here available. So for example, let's say you are going to employ one of your friend, or maybe your virtual assistant to manage your website. So this is your user. You are the owner, obviously, you are the administrator. But if you click on add new, you are going to find these options to assign someone else to your website so that they will be able to add contents, customize website, customize contents, and make whatever change you need, right? So we are not going to talk about this, but when you are going to work with any client, if they are not tech savvy, if they don't know how these user things works, you might have to help them get your user account created throughout their WordPress backend. So now let's go for profile. From here, you can change your image by using Gravatar, and then you can change more information about yourself. So I'm not going to spend time here on this part. This is not that important as of now. So now let's go for tools. From tools, you are going to find like available tools. Okay, Then you have got import, export, import. Then that means whenever you want to import any JSON file or let's say any XML file, you can simply import your blog post from other website. Then you have got export. If you want to export everything available on your WordPress website, you can simply click on export. This works as a backup, although this is not going to give you the complete solution. We have got some plugins where you have to work. So now let's go for the settings. Now, from settings, as we do for any other devices, any other functions, any other platforms, settings works for settings, right? So let's go for the general setting. We have got many more options. As you can see, general, writing, reading, discussion, media, permalinks, and privacy. So let me just go with general first. And as you can see, from general setting, we can do the same stuffs which we have done on the beginning of the video. From the customize section, we change this tagline, and again we'll be able to change our site title, you'll be able to change our tagline anytime we need, right, from this general setting. And then we have got WordPress address URL. As of now, we don't have this HTTPS, so let's keep it as it is now. But when you are going to implement this HTTPS, if I just show you here, this connection is secured. It is showing me this connection is secured because we have got HTTPS enabled. And if I take you to one of my portfolio websites, all right, so here my website has loaded, and this is one of my portfolio sites. I'm seeing some things broken because I have changed the theme on that site, but I didn't check this out. But if you just notice, I was here, as you can see, not secured because we don't have the SSL thing. And these are really advanced stuffs, and we are going to learn in our future videos. So currently, as of now, we can simply ignore. And let's go back here, where we are here. So I'm going to cross them out. All right, so here we have to make the change here on HTTPS after integrating all the required things on the backend and with any plugins if needed. And here we go, we have got the administrator email address. So from which email address you want to access this website, or your main email address for this website. This is what actually administration email address. And then we have got membership. Anyone can register if you want to get others to make comments by registering. If you want to get others to watch contents, read contents by getting registered, you can simply select this option. So these are a little bit of advanced, though not that much complex, but we are going to talk about this in future when you need it. So as of now, I can simply keep them as there. After that, you can change your site language. You can change the time zone. So I could select, let's say, +6, as I'm from Bangladesh. So +6 is our time zone. And then we have got time date format. You can simply select what is the date format you want to put. So I'd love to keep it as it is. This is not a big deal. And then week starts on, let's say our week starts from Sunday, and then let's click on save change. So we are going to talk and learn more about these settings in our future videos when we are going to do the real project. So I'm just going to give you some context. So let's go for writing here. From writing, we are going to find, as you can see, default post category. From here, we are going to be able to set the default category to be category for each of the posts or posts. So if I just open one post, I don't know if I'll be able to show you the category information here. If I have kept them open, yeah, as you can see, tags, I was being able to show you the tags. So if I click on MailChimp, I am going to find all the MailChimp based posts which are tagged with this MailChimp tag here. So my internet connection is a little slow, so I'm not going to spend more time here, because these are the things we are going to learn while we are going to work on actual projects or work on our future videos. Like, we're going to make blog posts, we are going to make pages, and then we are going to learn more about these things. And default post format is going to be standard. You can put it to whatever, like if you want to make your post format to video, you can put it if you're uploading video, but mostly we use standard. And then we have got this mail server. We don't have to think about this as of now. Let's go for reading. And from reading, you can select, as you can see, your homepage display. So let me show you the difference here. As you can see, currently it is selected to a static page, and for this reason we are seeing this specific page, right? But let me just show you here. If I take you to my learners.world website, you are going to find this is we are seeing the blog post here. and I have selected my home page to the blog post. But if I take you to my Azharul Rafy, which is my portfolio website, this one has this page as the home page, right? And we have selected this information, selected these pages from this section, right? As you can see, my home page is this one currently selected. So this page is being appeared. Post page, whenever I'm going to make any post, they are going to be appeared on the blog page. These are selected here, and we are going to learn more about this in future for sure. And then we have got this information, how many posts you want to show on the first page. Currently I have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 7 posts here on the first page, but for this setting we are getting 10 posts here, right? And we're going to learn more about this soon. So let me just discourage. I'm going to select this one, discourage search engines from indexing this site. We don't want to get our site indexed on search engines, so that, okay, as we are just currently making the demo contents here. So let's click on save changes if you have made the change. Other than that, let's keep it as it is. And then let's go for discussion. And from discussion, you are going to be able to set the rules for your comments, like how many comments a post should have, and what are the good words that you want to keep on the comments. And if you want to decide, or if you want to select some words like bad words, which you, whenever someone will use these words on your comments, these are going to be on the spam folder, or these are not going to be approved on your website. Automatically you can do these stuffs here, and you're going to learn more about these things later. I don't think this is an important part as of now. So let's go for media. And again, you have got this option, thumbnail size. If you want to get your uploaded contents on media should be customly just resized with a medium, or let's say here it is selected. As you can see, thumbnail size is 150 150. If you want, you can increase the height and width. So if you want all your uploaded contents to be minimized, all your uploaded contents to be resized with this size, you can simply keep this size as it is. You can increase this size as well, you can make it to 200 if you want, but I am going to keep it to 150, right? So let's keep them as they are. And then organize by uploads into month and year based folders. So organize, obviously we want to keep them organized, and they should be in chronological order. And then we have got permalinks. And here, from permalink settings, this is one of the important settings that you should know about SEO stuff. So mostly you might find this option selected, then name as your post title, or say the permalink. Actually permalink is these links. If I show you one post from here, this is the permalink, right? How to start freelancing as a beginner. So it is looking nice and it is SEO friendly here, but as it is currently selected with these dates in the post, before the post, so this is not actually making the post looking that friendly. But when we are going to select this post name here, we are going to find this exact format, your website URL, then the post title, or you can actually customize this link as well, and you're going to learn about this too. Then we have got this category base. We don't have to think about this as of now, so let's just click on save change. We want to keep this, so I just made the change. And then we have got the privacy settings. So here you have to create a privacy policy page, obviously, for your website. And by default, we get a privacy policy page from WordPress installation. Keep this as of now. If we need, we can make the change later. So this was it about the dashboard and the tools available. We are going to be able to customize all the things as we want. Let's say I don't want to see all of these widgets here, so simply go to screens, and if you just click on, let's say I don't want to see these widgets here, I can simply make them like this, right? They're blank and they're looking nice, other than just scattered. So when you will have lots of works done, when you will have lots of plugins and other tools installed on your WordPress website, you are going to find a mess here. And this is the way how we can clean up things. So let's say I want to keep only my WordPress, let's say welcome page. I just want to keep this, and then I want to keep my activity here. That's it. I don't want anything else. Or if you want, you can actually show all of these by clicking this way, right? So this was it, guys. I believe you have found a good base knowledge about the WordPress backend and the dashboard throughout this video. And in our next video, we are going straight to make posts on our website, and after that we are going to go for more customization. So if you have found this video helpful, then please give this video a like. If you have been enjoying this whole course, please share this course with your friends by sharing this course lectures on your social media sites, on Facebook, Twitter, or whatever platform you are using, and let them know that I have started this step-by-step course for all the beginners who are interested to start their freelance career and provide WordPress and Elementor based services. And again guys, please let me know your opinion by commenting below, and when you guys make comments, I get the feedback, like if I am being able to provide the information that is you are looking for, right? And if you have got any question, please let me know by commenting below. And as always, I'd love to mention again, please don't forget to join in our group which I have created from group. Let me show you this one. Okay, so I'm still working on the design and other content stuffs here, but please don't miss to join this course if you are serious enough to learn about WordPress and Elementor stuff. So as you can see, people are making comments and I'm replying on them. So if you have got any question, if you have got any problem throughout the journey, then you can simply ask me by making a post on this group, and I'm going to get back to you as soon as possible. So thank you so much for being with me. Have a good day.